Welcome back to Mechanical Pros, here with Quentin Butler. We're going to be talking about VRV4 condenser fan motors. This is a VRV4 condenser fan motor, super quiet fan. You can barely hear it running. It's got the submarine impeller on it. It's not your typical condenser fan or motor. Tell me what's different about this, Quentin, and how would you go about diagnosing, if it's a good motor?
Sure. So we have disassembled here a VRV4 condenser fan motor. We still have a few of the same basic components. We've got the stator, we have the rotor, we have the casing, and then of course we have a little rain guard to keep all the moisture out of there.
So this is just disassembled, right?
Sure. Yeah. Okay. Absolutely. Absolutely. And then we don't have the fan blade in the way here now, but basically you've got a couple of bearings, all right, and this guy just sits down in there just like this.
Like a glove.
Just fits like a glove. This isn't meant to be disassembled, but we took it apart just for video purposes. So it kind of just free spins on there.
Very cool.
Then we've got a wave plate that goes up top there. And this guy right here is just going to sit back down on there just like so. Then we've got four bolts that would hold this whole thing all together like a sandwich.
Okay.
Then we've got our nice little rain guard that goes over top of this.
So if I was to walk up on that, that doesn't look like your typical condenser fan.
No, it's a little bit different. It's a variable speed motor, ECM type motor. It's got two connectors as opposed to, a traditional condenser fan motor. But we can go through how to check this thing out. So let's say that you've got a condenser fan fault or something like that. You wanted to see if it's the actual motor or the fan driver board. The first thing you want to do is check out the condenser fan motor itself. So first you want to power down the module.
Okay.
Give it a few minutes, unplug your connectors. And then the next thing you're going to have to do is break out your meter. Today we're using the VRV4 service manual for reference. We're just going to untangle your meter leads.
Yeah.
We're going to turn it to resistance or ohms. Okay. And so your first connector has the three wires. Basically, you're just looking for balanced resistance between each of the windings. So we're going to go between red and white first. We've got 6.8. We're going to take our red lead, move it over here to the black. We've got 6.7, 6.8. We're going to move over here to the white. So we have balanced resistance between each of the windings. So that checks out good.
Okay.
The next thing that you have is this second connector. Now for this connector, you've probably noticed I have these skinny little meter leads. Traditional meter leads are not going to fit inside of these little connectors. But according to our service manual here, our gray wire is ground. So we'll start by putting one of our meter leads. I can get the lead to go in there. Let's try it on the top side. Oh, that's because this motor's bad. Let's get the other one back up here.
You want to get the other one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. So, now we're going to check this connector. That's a good place for us to start. Okay. And then we've got these other three wires. We've got U, V, and W. So yellow is your U wire, blue is your V wire, and then orange is your W wire. So I'm going to take my black lead and stick it in the gray wire connection. And then we'll start at yellow. And we're just looking for consistency amongst each one of these. So we have 20.8 K ohms on the yellow wire, 20.9 K ohms on the blue wire.
Does it tell you it's the blue wire?
It's not that fancy. That's a nice meter, but it's not that nice.
That would be really nice.
And then on the last wire, we have 21.1 K ohms.
Yeah.
So that's pretty balanced. We want to be within 20% on this connector. Now we're going to move on to the pink wire, which is labeled as our VCC. This is our next check. Going to put the black meter lead in there, and then we're going to do the same thing. We're going to start at one end and work our way to the other. We start at yellow. We've got 12.1 K ohms go to blue, we have 12.1 k-ohms. Then we go to orange, we have 12.3 k-ohms. So that's balanced. So judging by this test, we can assume that this condenser fan motor is in good shape.
Okay.
If you're in the field, the first thing that you're going to want to do if you have a condenser fan fault is make sure that the blade spins freely. If it doesn't spin freely, or if it has like a bunch of abnormal noise, that'd be indication of bearing failure. But as far as checking this motor electrically, we just cover that. This is a good motor.
Okay, great. Thanks. All right, so hit that like, hit that subscribe, and we'll see you next on Mechanical Pros.